Good morning, Church of St. Paul's family and friends. We're starting a new series today, Unanswered Prayer. And I want to discuss with you, what is prayer? The prayers of Jesus in the Bible were really conversations he had with his Abba, with God. In these, he teaches us by his example that we should open our heart and soul when we pray to God as an expression of our faith in him. An old hymn written by an obscure lay preacher in the mid-19th century praises prayer as follows. Sweet hour of prayer, you call me from a world of care and bids me at my Father's throne to make all my wants and wishes known. In seasons of distress and grief, my soul had often found relief and oft escaped the tempter's snare by thy return, sweet hour of prayer. To this old man, prayer was the way to the Father's throne. Now we know that our Lord Jesus told his disciples many times, watch and pray, and he teaches us to make all our wants and wishes known to the Father in prayer as an expression of our faith and trust in him. In Luke 11 verses 9 and 10, this is what he says. So I say to you, ask and it will be given to you. Seek and you will find. Knock and the door will be opened. For everyone who asks receives. The one who seeks finds. And to the one who knocks, the door will be opened. Jesus prayed often, long before daybreak and deep into the night. He was somewhere secluded in conversation with his dad, seeking his guidance, enjoying his presence. Jesus prayed before all the life-changing events of his ministry, like the miracles, turning water into wine at the wedding feast in Cana, healing people, body, mind, and soul, giving sight to the blind, raising the dead as though they were just asleep, and feeding the multitudes with nothing more than a little boy's lunch. Jesus also prayed for strength and for endurance in Gethsemane before his arrest. Father, if possible, when the Roman soldiers were nailing him to the cross, Father, forgive them, they don't know. Experiencing the sum total of our sin. My God, why? And as he wiped sin's slate clean with his blood, it is accomplished. Returning home, Father, into thy hands. Jesus showed us how to embrace the power of prayer, the gift from God given in Eden for all his children to share, so that we may know we have a Father that cares about us. Deep down, don't we all want to feel accepted and cared for? Don't we want to know we belong to someone, somewhere? God programmed each of us with a deep desire to be loved, not tolerated, but chosen by God, handpicked. He invites us to be part of his family, and he calls this invitation prayer. So let us accept God's invitation and pray. We may not always receive exactly what we want when we want it, but we shall always receive that which is best for us when God finds the right time for us. Let us pray. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done as it is on earth, so it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those that sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine, Lord, is the kingdom, and the glory, and the power. Amen.